In last video, you watch how can we shoot with the aperture priority program. In this video, I will tell you how can we use the shutter priority program. In this mode, you can see how I can take moving cars pictures in a blur effect and in a motion effect. Let's go. Before watching the effects of a shutter priority mode, just rewind what we have learned in the last video. First, we learned about program mode. In program mode, camera will do everything according to the specific scene. Then you watch aperture mode. In aperture, camera control the shutter speed and you control the aperture. Today you will learn about shutter priority mode. But before going further, you will watch what is a shutter and how it works. Friends, if you want my channel will grow, so kindly join my channel membership by paying very small amount. You will get free badges, special emojis, shutouts, free image review, special discussions, social assets and free perks and giveaway you never enjoyed before. Just click on join button and enjoy membership perks. Thanks. What is shutter? Shutter speed exists because of a something known as your camera, which shutter simply put is a curtain in front of the camera sensor that stays closed until the camera fires. When the camera fires, the shutter opens and fully expose the camera sensor to the light that has passed through your lens. After the sensor is done collecting the light, the shutter closes, immediately stopping the light from hitting the sensor. The button that fires the camera is also called shutter or shutter button, but it triggers the shutter to open and close. When it comes to a DSLR camera shutter, there are basic mechanisms: the mirror box, the bottom door and the top door. When you look through a DSLR viewfinder, you are essentially looking through a series of mirrors that get their light directly from the lens. When you click the shutter button, that system of the mirrors flips upwards to allow light to pass to the sensor. This is why the viewfinder goes black for a short amount of the time when taking photos. Once the mirror is flipped upward, a small door will move from top to bottom, exposing the sensor beneath. After that, another door will fall down, covering up the entire sensor. This process can vary in the time depending on the length of the shutter speed. Sometimes the shutter speed can be so fast that your camera sensor won't be entirely exposed at any one time. After the second door closes, your mirror will fall back into place. The door will then reset their original position underneath. This entire process from mirror up to mirror down is known as an actuation. It is typically very easy to find the shutter speed on cameras that have the top panel. The shutter speed is typically located on the left corner as circled. If your camera does not have a top LCD panel, like some entry-level DSLRs, you can look through the viewfinder where you will see the shutter speed on the bottom left side. And if your camera has neither a top LCD panel nor a viewfinder, like many mirrorless cameras, you can see your shutter speed simply by looking on the back display screen. Shutter speed is a measurement of the time the shutter is open, shown in seconds or fraction of second. 1 second, 1:2 second, 1:4 second, 1:250 seconds, 1:500 and more seconds. The faster the shutter speed, the shorter the time the image sensor is exposed to light. The slower the shutter speed, the longer the time the image sensor is exposed to light. If you are photographing a subject that is in a motion, you will get different effects at different shutter speeds. Fast shutter speeds will freeze the motion, while slow shutter speeds introducing blur from the two sources, camera movement, camera shake and subject movement. In the other words, the faster the shutter speed, the easier it is to photograph. The subject without blur and freeze motion, and the smaller the effects of a camera shake. In contrast, slower shutter speeds are suited to the suggestions such as that of flowing water or other moving subjects. Changing the shutter speed gives you control over whether to freeze or suggest motion. A darker picture is produced when the shutter moves very quickly and only allows light to touch the imaging sensor for a teeny fraction of a second. So a shutter speed of 1:2 of the second will allow more light to touch the image sensor and will produce a brighter picture than a shutter speed of 1:200 of a second. Now come to the shutter priority mode, S or TV. This is the opposite of the aperture priority mode. When you select this mode, you control the shutter speed and camera controls the aperture. Again, the end result is that the camera is looking for a balanced exposure by assigning an aperture to your chosen shutter speed. This allows the photographer to reduce the duration that the shutter is open to freeze fast moving action, or conversely leave the shutter open longer to allow blur and movement to appear in the frame. Sports photographers will often use shutter priority mode to let the camera know they are looking to freeze action. Now you can watch how we can take moving object with the shutter priority mode. Let's rewind. I am going to shoot this car in motion. Camera settings, shooting speed continues high. It is always beneficial when we use an action shot. Autofocus mode to continuous. In continuous autofocus, AFC, the camera will continues to focus if the shutter release button is kept pressed halfway after the camera focuses. Because the camera continues to focus up to the moment the shutter release button is pressed all the way down. This mode is a good choice for the subjects that are in motion. Shooting mode already selected to shutter priority. I set shutter speed 1:60. It is not an ideal speed to freeze the action. Let us watch what happened. I took the 5 images and aperture was set by the camera. You can see with the speed of 1:60, camera set the aperture to f/25. It was too narrow. Because sun is bright, additionally by mistake I did not change the ISO 400 that was not required here. You can shoot it with ISO 100 in this light. With selecting slow shutter speed, the background is blurred and the wheels of car are showing the motion. It was blurred, it does not mean it is a result of camera shake, but it is a result to show the motion of movement of car. Now come to the second shot. Again I took few images with continuous speed, but I changed speed 1:60 to 1:400. Check the result. You can see with the speed of 1:400, camera set the aperture to f9. So it is clear now, if our speed is low, camera set aperture narrow to allow enough light to come on the sensor, so image will not be overexposed. At the same time, if we set higher speed, camera set the bigger aperture to come more light to the sensor, so image will not be underexposed. So in this image, you can see the car movement was freezed more than previous shot and background was less blurred. So you can also see the less movement of the wheels. If you will set speed higher than 500 or 800, car will completely freeze like car is not moving, just stopped. Now it is up to you what is your requirement. So in the last, I again want to tell you, the faster the shutter speed, the shorter the time the image sensor is exposed to light. The slower the shutter speed, the longer the time the image sensor is exposed to light. The image taken on the speed of 1:60, take the narrow aperture of f/25. On the contrast, the image taken on the speed of 1:400, aperture set by the camera is f9. That's all for today. Soon I will come with another part of this series. Thanks for watching.